I would suggest sending in troops or offering a bounty.
How do they even manage to find their way in?
Perhaps the pathways were connected from old dwarven tunnels. Orcs have been known to settle in such places.
Dwarves, you say? What a truly troublesome lot they are. They're like moles. No matter how many holes we close, another pops up. Long ago, when the elves and dwarves split between east and west because of a war, the dwarves hid in these lands, waiting for the elves to attack. Even after the war ended, they continued digging holes, eventually turning the golden country into a dungeon. I've even heard that the dungeon continues to grow because of the descendants of those very dwarves.
Let us move on from unsubstantiated rumors. Here are the drawings of the magic circles. They are in the usual elvish language, and according to the penmanship, it is the same author, and there are no signs of anyone else modifying them at all. There's no mistaking it. The lord of the dungeon, or should I say the mad mage, drew these magic circles.
Is this individual an elf?
I cannot say with certainty, but it's unlikely a tall man or dwarf cast it.
This is concerning. The thing is, the other day, I received a letter from the elves of the west. It said, the dungeon belongs to us. Relinquish it.
How utterly conceited. They're the ones who gave the lands to the humans after taking and squandering those lands from the dwarves. Just ignore them.
This land was bestowed to me by the king of the elves, so I'm afraid that's not possible.
They'll take the entire island.
I certainly hope not. There is most likely a vast amount of riches still in the bowels of that dungeon.
My lord, their objective is not any material treasure, but the immortality spell cast on the dungeon. This spell that tethers the soul to the body is still a great mystery. And once that mystery becomes unraveled, its value will far exceed any amount of gold. We should solve it before the elves do.
So we should trace all of the magic circles and study them?
That's not enough! A powerful spell such as this is bound to have a schematic. You should seek it out. After we get our hands on it, then you can agree to give them back the dungeon. Once they realize we possess that valuable knowledge, the elves will see you as an equal. No, they will kneel before you to curry your favor.
You think so? So where do you think it might be?
Isn't it obvious? The lord of the dungeon would have possession over it.
So we should keep sending in adventurers to search the premises?
That is correct.